राम टूअल, इन आवर डेली लाइफ व्हाट वी आर ऑब्जर्विंग, वी आर गेटिंग डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ पैटर्न्स अराउंड अस. सपोज इफ द स्टूडेंट्स आर स्टैंडिंग इन द प्रेयर ग्राउंड, देन दे आर स्टैंडिंग ऑन अ पर्टिकुलर गैप, मीन्स अ पैटर्न दे आर फॉलोइंग. इन क्लासरूम इफ द बेंचेस आर अरेंज्ड, देन पैटर्न वी आर गेटिंग देयर. On a particular distance, on a particular gap, we are placing the benches. Similarly, if you are observing a sunflower, then the petals of sunflower give you a different pattern. Same as the holes, if you are observing in honeycomb, if you are observing the grains of a maize cob, if you are taking and if you are observing the grains, then you are observing a certain pattern. If you are observing the sky, then the stars we are getting at night, and that stars we are observing, they are standing on a different pattern, they are forming some pattern, and that patterns are called sequence. Same for the number. And here in this chapter, in the fifth chapter, arithmetic progression, we are going to learn some patterns. Either the patterns for the numbers, if you are placing some numbers on a particular interval or on a particular gap, or you are observing some object and if you are placing that object in a certain pattern, then all these things are called as the sequence and series for arithmetic progression. What we have in class 10th in arithmetic progression, we are going to learn some patterns, and in that pattern, if you are observing the terms, the succeeding terms, if you are observing, then you are getting the succeeding term by adding a fixed number to the preceding term. This we are going to learn in this chapter, arithmetic progression, and we are also able to find the nth term and the sum of n consecutive terms. Means if a particular number is given, then we are able to find that terms of the series or sequence, and we are also able to find the sum of the numbers. For example, suppose someone is telling or asking what is the sum of first 100 natural number, then by using the concept of sum of n terms, we are able to find the sum of n 100 natural number, or you may take 1 lakh natural numbers or any kinds of pattern. Then here in this chapter, the term we are getting sequence, and sequence means the list of things that are in order. And here we are taking the numbers, and we are placing the numbers in some order. For example, suppose I am taking the number as 3, 5, 7, 9, and the first term we are getting as 3, the second we are getting as 5. These terms are also known as the element or member, and these dots were indicating about this series is infinite series. And here if you are observing the pattern, then we are getting some squares we are observing, and if the number of unit square in a square with side 1, 2, 3, 4 you are observing there. If unit side is 1, then we are getting 1 square. If 2, then 4 square. If 3, we are getting 9. The square of these numbers and the that number of squares we are observing here. If you are taking 4, then the 16 square we are getting. The squares of the number we know, 1 square is 1, 2 square is 4, 3 square 9, 4 square is 16. Similarly, 5 square, if you are taking, then we are getting 25 square. And this is also a pattern. In that pattern, we are getting the square of the given numbers having the side 1, 2, 3 or 4 unit I am showing here. Then we are getting two kind of series. One is finite series, another one is infinite series. And if the sequence goes on forever, like the last example, then that is called infinite sequence. Otherwise, if the number of terms are fixed, then that is called finite sequence. here we are observing a picture, and in this picture if you are placing some object like this one, then here in this column we are placing three object, here we are placing five, here we are placing seven, then 9, then 11, and if you are observing these numbers, then we are getting a certain pattern. All these numbers we are observing, and the difference between these two we are getting 2, 5, 3 we are getting 2, 7, 5, 2, 9, 7, 2, 11, 9, 2, means the difference we are getting as 2. A certain pattern we are observing. If we have to find how many object we have to place in the next column, then we are adding 2. Arithmetic progression, or we are calling this as arithmetic sequence, is a sequence in which a constant is added to each term to get the next term in the sequence. How will you get the arithmetic progression or sequence? By adding a constant to each term to get the next term. In the preceding term we are getting that constant, and the constant term is called as common difference. We are calling the constant, that constant term which we are adding for finding the next term, we are calling that as common difference, and we are representing by small d. Here I am taking an example, and in this example I am taking some numbers 2, 6, 10, 14, and if I am observing this, then 2 plus 4 we are getting 6, 6 plus 4 10, 10 plus 4 14, and so on. This one is infinite series. Now the difference between these number is 4, means the value of common difference, if you have to tell, then we are able to write the common difference is 4. If you are subtracting any two number, we are getting 4. Then here the same pattern we are observing. If you are going through the concept, then we are either you are placing some object or you are writing some numbers, then we are getting an arithmetic progression if the common difference between any two consecutive term is same. Then arithmetic progression. What is an arithmetic progression then? Arithmetic progression is a sequence of number such that the difference of any two successive member is a constant. In the previous definition, in the previous slide, we have learned that we are adding a constant number to get the next number. And in other way, if you are observing the same thing, then the difference of any two successive member is constant. Means that the value, that that value of D, the common difference is constant. If you are observing here the example, then example I am taking here 1, 5, 9, 13, 17 and so on. And the difference between these numbers we are getting as 4. 5 minus 1 is 4, 9 minus 5 is 4. Means the common difference is 4. Therefore this series is in AP. Either you are observing the concept that if you are adding a certain number or if you are subtracting the preceding number from the succeeding one. Both are the same thing. Then here I am taking the XY plane, and on the X plane I am representing N. N means the number of terms, and AN I am writing here, then AN is the nth term. Then what we are observing in the coordinate, these coordinates are increasing by a certain pattern. If in the X coordinate, if you are adding 1, we are getting 2. If you are adding 1 to the X coordinate here, we are getting 3. Then 3 plus 1 is 4. Then 4 plus 1 is 5. A certain pattern we are getting, we are observing here. If you are adding 1 to each one, we are getting the next coordinate. Same we are doing for Y, Y coordinate. We are adding 1, we are getting 2. 2 plus 1, 3. 3 plus 1, 4. 4 plus 1, 5. Means a certain pattern we are observing here, and this pattern is also in AP. The coordinates are in AP. Arithmetic progression series we are observing because the difference between the coordinate we are getting as 1. And if you are considering the term, then A1, A2, A3 up to AN we are getting as the terms of the AP. A1 we are calling as the first term. and d is the common difference we are taking. Then the first term is a1 and the second term is a2, and how will you get a2? Then we are adding d to the first term. If you are adding common difference to the first term, we are getting the second term. Same if we have to find the third term, then we are adding the same value d to the second term. If you are adding the common difference d to the second term, we are getting the third term, and so on. Means for finding the next number, just only add the common difference. And how will you get the common difference if the series is given? Then we have to subtract any two consecutive terms. Then this you have to remember, d is constant for arithmetic progression. In the exercise we are getting some questions, and the first exercise and the question we are getting there, the given sequence is in AP or not. Means you have to check the common difference. If you are finding the common difference between any two consecutive terms and that should be same for the series, it means that yes, the given series is in AP. First term we are taking A1, the second term we are taking A2. Then how will you get the next term? By adding the common difference to the previous term. Here if you are observing a pattern, if you are, suppose I am considering some balls and if I am placing these balls, then in the first row I am placing one ball, in the second one we are placing three, then five, then seven, then nine, 11. These balls we are placing in a row. And if you are observing a pattern, then each time we are getting the similar pattern. 3 minus 1 we are getting 2. If you are cancelling these, then we are getting 2. Same for 5 and 3. 5 minus 3 is 2. 7 minus 5 is 2. Here we are getting the common difference as 2. Let us consider some example, and here I am taking in the first example 2, 5, 8, 11. And if you are observing, 2 plus 3 we are getting 5, 5 plus 3 we are getting 8, 8 plus 3 we are getting 11. Means the common difference we are getting 3. If you are subtracting, then 5 minus 2 is 3, 8 minus 5 is 3, 11 minus 8 is 3. Means the difference we are getting as 3. Therefore, this is in AP, having common difference 3. If you are considering the second example, then 3, 9, 15, 20. Then 9 minus 3. 9 minus 3, we are getting 6. 15 minus 9, we are getting 6. But if you are considering here 20 minus 15, then you are getting 5. The common difference we are not getting the same. Therefore, this sequence is not in. In the third example, we are getting the series as 5, 1, minus 3, minus 7, 1, minus 5, we are getting minus 4, minus 3, minus 1, we are getting minus 4, minus 7, minus 3, we are getting minus 4. Therefore, the common difference is minus 4, and yes, this series is in AP. Then whether the given series in AP or not, this if you have to find, then what we are doing, we are just finding the common difference between the given consecutive terms. And if the common difference is same, then the series is in AP, otherwise it is not in AP, arithmetic progression. Some properties we are getting for arithmetic progression. The first two we have done. If a constant is added to or subtracted, if a constant is added or it is subtracted from each term of an arithmetic progression, then the resulting sequence is also an arithmetic progression. Same we are getting for multiplication and division. If you are multiplying the each term of the progression or divide the each term of the progression by a non-zero constant, then the resulting sequence is always an arithmetic progression. And if you are adding some number constant number to each term, if you are subtracting a constant number to each term, if you are multiplying, if you are dividing, we are getting arithmetic progression. And if you are considering an AP, then the terms we are taking as A1, A2, A3 up to AN, the nth term, and these are written as the first term we are getting as A, the second we are getting by adding the common difference to the first term, then it is A plus D, the same we are getting as A plus 2D, then A plus 3D, A plus 4D and so on, and the nth term we are getting as A plus N minus 1 into D, where A is first term, N is the number of terms and D is common difference. Here if you are observing this, then suppose I stairs you are taking and then the terms we are observing here, the first we are getting as A, then we are adding D to for getting the next, then A plus 2D and so on. And similarly, we are getting A plus N minus 1 into D, means the nth term we are getting as A plus N minus 1 into D. And this formula you have to learn. The nth term of an AP is A plus N minus 1 into D. In place of A1, we are using A because the first term we are taking as A. And the AN represented here the nth term in the sequence. A1 the first term in the sequence. N the number of terms and D we know the common difference. Then AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. This formula we have to learn and we have to use for finding the nth term or for finding the number of term, for finding the common difference. This we are using in the second presentation. We are going to use this. We are going to use the learn of this, how to use this, then we are getting in the second presentation. What we are learning from these, the difference we are calling as the common difference of an AP and denoted by D. The members we are calling as the term. The first member is called the first term of the series. We denote common difference by D. These things we know. Similarly, the terms we are taking as A1, A2, A3, A4 and so on, then the common difference between each consecutive term is same for an AP. The terms we are getting as A, A plus D, A plus 2D, A plus 3D, A plus 4D and so on, this we have to use. And for a if the AP series has the last term, then it is a finite arithmetic progression. And if you are not getting the last term, then it is called infinite arithmetic progression. Then here if you are observing, I am taking a month calendar for the March 2020. And if you are observing the date, then these numbers. If you are observing, yes, it is in arithmetic progression because the difference between each number we are getting as 1. If you are observing these numbers diagonally, then 9 minus 1 is 8, 17 minus 9, 8, 25 minus 17, 8. Similarly, we are getting different patterns. If you are observing here column wise, then 10 minus 3, 7, 17 minus 10, 7, 24 minus 7, 17, 31 minus 24, 7, means the common difference is same. Means these numbers are arranged, and if the number of days are divided in a week, then that should be in, that is in a different particular fixed pattern. And by using the concept of mathematics, we are able to form these kinds of calendar. Then at last we have the arithmetic mean. If अरिथमेटिक मीन, हाउ विल यू गेट अरिथमेटिक मीन इफ सपोज सी नंबर्स कैन बी इंसर्टेड बिटवीन टू नंबर्स ए एंड बी. सपोज वी आर टेकिंग अ नंबर सी एंड द नंबर सी इज इंसर्टेड बिटवीन द गिवन टू नंबर ए एंड बी, देन सी इज कॉल्ड द अरिथमेटिक मीन ऑफ ए एंड बी. एंड हाउ विल यू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ सी? इट मीन्स डैट वी आर गेटिंग एन अरिथमेटिक प्रोग्रेशन एज ए सी बी. मीन्स बी इज इंसर्टेड बिटवीन ए एंड बी, देन सी इज कॉल्ड द अरिथमेटिक मीन बिटवीन ए एंड बी. एंड हाउ विल यू गेट दिस? देन बाई यूजिंग द सेम कॉन्सेप्ट. इफ द सीरीज इज इन ए पी देन द कॉमन डिफरेंस शुड बी सेम. कॉमन डिफरेंस बिटवीन सी एंड ए एंड द कॉमन डिफरेंस बिटवीन बी एंड सी. If you are finding this, then C minus A we are getting as the common difference between C and A, and between B and C we are getting B minus C. If you are taking C on the other side and A on this side, then we are getting 2C equal to A plus B, and C is equal to A plus B upon 2. Means arithmetic mean is same as the mean. We are adding just two numbers and we are dividing that value by 2. Average we are taking. In class 8 we have familiar about this term average, and that average is called arithmetic mean. Here I am taking a statement problem, and in this this is given Rohan's salary in his first year is 2000 and he will be getting increment of 500 every year. He get an increment of 500 every year, then his salary for the first, second, third, fourth will be what we are getting. In the first year we are getting 2000, Rohan is getting 2000. In second, Rohan getting 2500, then 3000, then 3500, so on, 4000 and 4500, and so on. Similarly, this increment he is getting in the salary. What we are observing, a different pattern, a pattern we are observing there. In that pattern we are getting the difference between any two consecutive number as rupees 500, and between the consecutive year salary is constant. We are getting that 500 rupees is constant increment in between the 2 years. Then on the basis of these presentation you have to solve some question from exercise 5.1 NCERT question, and you may solve the last question of this exercise also. In that one you have to observe whether the given sequence is in AP or not. Sai Ram to all.